So have you, we have heard this message, I think I shared about 3 months back. But I started, but I could not finish it. So today, I'm going to continue that message. Heart is a very important organ, correct? Both physically, both spiritually. But heart spiritually doesn't mean the same thing as the physical heart. But no. Three kinds of heart in the ministry. Heart, we have to deal with the heart. Ministry or spiritual things, everything, we have to deal with the heart. In this, I'm going to talk in the Apostles, Acts of the Apostles, 16th chapter. It deals with the three hearts. The very same chapter, three hearts are there. One is a closed heart, then possessed heart, and hardened heart. We come across all these three things. Sometimes this is also happening in our life also. Our heart may be also in that state. So be very sensitive to this message. You let the word of God come, speak to everyone today. So here, the churches were strengthened in the faith and increased in number daily. So here it speaks about the two things, revival, strengthened in faith, evangelism, increased in number daily. So if any revival should result in an evangelism. If it doesn't result in an evangelism, that is not at all a true revival. So revival, the outcome of the revival will be the evangelism. So that we have to, so we are praying for the revival. So we have to have a passion for the evangelism also. So I know first the thing is, any ministry, we need the guidance of God. So we can see the whole leading of the Holy Spirit. We have so many things, but what I have to do, what this church has to do, what, and the timing also is very important. We have to move by the Spirit of God, otherwise we cannot. So there is so much of prayer. It's all now we can, how to find it, how to find the timing, how to find the things. No, but we have to spend so much of time in prayer to find the, as a church. No, there's no other better way than the Lord. The Holy Spirit definitely guide us through. No, okay, you know that Paul, he was deciding to go to Asia, but it's he would have stayed in Asia, but in this, no, God turned. He asked him to move all Asia and Macedonia. The first, he stepped into Europe. It was a very, very small beginning, you see. But it has, but otherwise he would have only ministered in Asia. But the Spirit of God moved him and pushed him to the Europe. Today, no. Even people in India think that the Christianity has come from west to east. But really, the gospel has gone from the east to the west. So God, we have to have the clear vision. It is the work of God. The church, we cannot play with church. church is the God working behind. The Spirit of God is working behind. I really tremble to come and speak in the church. I cannot take things very easy. So we have to be very sensitive to the Spirit of God. Lord, what I have to do? Because it affects eternity. It affects everything. So we are doing a serious business. Serious thing, everyone. A church is not a simple thing. It's the greater and wisdom of God. So we have to praise God. We are part of the church. We are part of the plan of God. We are part of the working of God. We are part of the thing that we are here. So we have to praise God for that. So Philippi is the first place that the gospel went in Europe. This is one of the important thing, no? Paul and Silas only went there initially in the ministry journey. But when they went, this was a very thing, no? When they went, Dr. Luke, who he is a writer, he is a physician, he is a writer, he also accompanied them. So actually, Silas and Dr. Luke and Timothy. So four. So the group has become from two has become four, and they ministered in Philippi. So now we'll come to the transformation of the heart. So transformation heart is an internal thing, no? It is not outside. So number one thing is a closed heart. Our hearts need to be opened so that God can work in our heart. Can any one of you please read this verse? You see, when Paul went to Philippi, God, he had a vision, he rushed. He immediately, they managed to go there. Because God spoke, when they landed in Philippi, whether anybody came to receive him, whether he got any clue, has any friends, probably not. Nothing. No. Nobody to receive. Nobody to tell him. Nothing. He went. Just these four people went to Philippi. Normally, if you look at when the way that Paul ministered in Asia was, that he used to find some Jewish synagogues, and he entered into it, and he will first preach. Then when they reject, he will minister in the time, he will contact and minister in the nearby places, and he will go to the heathen. That is the way that it worked. But when he came to the Philippi, not many Jews there, not a synagogue even there. So, what one riverside, they started praying. So he had a vision. He is the plan of God. He came to Philippi. Now what he is doing? He just in the riverside, he all the four, what they can do is they can just pray. And they found one group of women. Very interesting to find that the first thing they saw was a group of women. In Europe, the whole of Europe, who responded was a woman. First convert is a woman. So everything, no? How he touched, and it happened in Philippi, everywhere, there are one person touched and the household was saved. That a woman, this woman, not only the God opened the heart of this woman to heed the things Paul said, but his whole family were saved. That is beautiful. God doesn't know. God pulls someone, but God is working. God is at work. So our families will definitely be saved. Okay. The Bible says Lydia is a worshipper of God. I don't think she has shut her heart. She is already open. Her heart was open. She is the warp. Oh, everywhere we see people that seeker of the truth. I want to know the truth. People want long for God. You see, God has already, she is a worshipper of the, but the Lord has opened the heart of her heart to heed the things. The Lord, when we open the things, no, God also opens something in our heart. You see, even inside the church, the Laodicean church, so I stand at the knock and knock. So the church also, it happens, no, people have a closed heart. It's not only outside. Inside the church also, the same thing, a closed heart can happen. So we will be close to God. We may think I am inside the church. Has I opened my heart to Jesus to enter in? Is Jesus outside my heart or right inside my heart? That is something that we have to think about it. So what happens if anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come to him and dine with him, and he dine with me. That is very important. First, no, you see, first dine with him, and he dine with me. You see, when somebody comes into the house, so we open the door for them to enter in and give something for them to eat. No, it is our thing, hospitality. So people take it, eat it, dine with us, correct? Then, as a guest, then next item is, and he with me. He becomes a host. You see, when we invite him, we should, he becomes a host. We don't like, no, people coming to our house, act like a host and going everywhere, and if you will drive them out. But no, Jesus is the Lord. He doesn't want to be a guest, but he wants to take the everywhere, no, Emmaus, or so many places when you see Jesus, wherever he went, he took the position of a host. There, he was looked as a stranger, and when they entered into the house in Emmaus, Jesus started and breaking the bread, they identified that very act of breaking the bread and give them, they identified, oh, he is Jesus. Even after the resurrection, they tried to, they went for fishing, and Jesus came there. Is there any fish? No fish. So you put at the right. And there also, you see, Jesus, we can know, he started sharing them. So the very act they could identify that he is the Lord. He is Jesus. So in our life, when he comes to us, he doesn't come like a guest. He wants to be the Lord. We should be able to accept him. Lord, you can come. This area, don't go. You come, you only enter into the living room. Don't come to my bedroom. Don't come, I have something here. Like that, no? We have so many doors in the house. No, only one door. But no, we don't hide. We have to be open. He wants to be all in our heart. Then only God can work. We have to accept him as a... So, he should be... Another thing is, he should be comfortable in us. Correct? If you have dirty things in us, can God comfortable in your heart? Be very careful about your heart. Don't defile your heart. I know a person. The heart, he had a problem with the wall. In the physical heart, what is the door? Another name is a wall. One of the wall malfunctioning, no? There are so many walls in the heart. So, no, what happens? It should, one direction flow. So, if the good blood should come there. If the bad blood in that passage if enters, that is a problem. He had a lot of problem because, you know, in the wall, there was some small leakage that the bird blood was going in, and he caused a lot of problem for him. He had to go for operation and for changing the... So many things happened. But the thing is, you know, even a little bad blood then cause so much of a damage to the heart. The whole functioning of your body is getting affected. Your hand pain, your kidney affects, this affects, the whole system is collapsed. Just a little bad blood. So you see, your heart, how much you have to keep clean, holy. Think about it. You can see any movies. You have the freedom, but be careful. If you are now uncomfortable, if the Spirit of God urges you, just stop it. I praise God. I don't see movies. Maybe if I have seen movies, I would have been dwell in the movies, but I don't. But why should we go into that and corrupt and try to eliminate out of it? Stop it. If you think that is corrupting your heart, stop right there. That is not going to in any way it will help you. This is very important. So, you just judge yourself. Can my Jesus dwell in my heart? Is he comfortable staying in my heart? Have I really given my heart to him? Is he a guest or is he a host? Do you want Jesus to be just a guest for you? I want to be my Lord. I want him to take my reins. I want him to take everything in my life. I want him to be lead me in every decisions, every part of my life. Oh, child of God, your heart, wholly give to the Lord. Wholly give to the Lord. 100% you give to the Lord. Let him be your Lord, your God. That is the secret in your life. So, this thing really is so marvelous for me. They went. This woman, God opened the heart. What she is telling? Come and stay at my house. And she persuaded us. You see, four guys have come from somewhere. And they have stole something about Jesus. What? They don't know about the background. They don't know who they are. Now what they tell? You come and stay us. They, not only that, not namesake. Oh, come. And in the heart, oh, they should not come. Not like that. They were really, really, they persuaded, they forced them, no? To come to their house. You see, that is when our heart is open, our heart is open for the ministry of God. We will love the people of God. We love the minister of God. We love the work of God. Our heart will be broadened. Our money will be for the work of God. We will do anything for God. That is the thing, no? If your heart is open, otherwise, you can say, if it is something corrupted or something going after, you will say so many excuses, this and that, and they criticize and complain. Everything will come out of you. But if your heart, you know, you will love the ministry, love the church. Your heart will be open. Your heart will be broadened. Your heart will be a great change. You will be totally changed. That is what will happen if your heart is opened. A great question. Is my heart open? And no. Another thing is, when your heart is open, you will get the revelation of God. You will see the mysteries of heaven. God can even take you to heaven. Our God is who has done it for Paul. Can't he not do it for you? No, he can take you. He can show you mysteries. You can dwell. You did not only want, so many things are there. It will come as a mystery. It will come as a surprise for you. If you can just wholly give yourself to God. So is my heart open for the Lord? Is my heart open just this question everyone right now ask. So great. Jesus coming into our heart is very important. Very important. I appreciate I learned with pastor one thing. Every time he will ask straight question. Have you saved? Whether you have accepted Jesus, your heart changed, everything. No, I'm also very much concerned, not superficial things. We need our hearts to be changed. We cannot just, that is very, very, our heart should be the place for the Lord to dwell in. So that is our parameter. That is our spirituality. That is where our change should happen. We should change. The people around should be changed. The heart should be changed. Not only Paul. Paul changed the heart of that one woman, Lydia. Okay. So, closed heart. Number two is a possessed heart. What is that? Please, anyone please read. You see here, next a great problem, people were possessed by the evil spirit. So many times we think when there is a bad thing, we will easily identify that it is a evil spirit. No? There is some kind of a convulsion or a shaking or I have seen in so many meetings in India, people will come with four or five people cannot control a person and they will take it. And when the man of God just prays, immediately he'll be healed. He'll be all right. This is a very different type of spirit. What type of spirit? Who brought her masters much profit by fortune telling. This spirit, you see, much profit. A great industry was going on. Great business was going on. That woman was totally controlled by a spirit of divination that it came upon her, and what? Totally she was controlled, and by that a great business, a commercial things were going on. Just think of it. Satan also will come in the form of an angel. Discern all the spirits. Because something good happens, doesn't mean it comes from God. You see, that woman was possessed by the Jesus Christ. When he came to the world, every day he casted out devils. You see, there were not this. They came people with dumb and deaf. You see, medical term, no? They may have a thing, but Jesus rebuked the spirit. And the dumb person spoke and he was able to hear. Even so many diseases are caused by the demon. So, that is okay. But no, now what they do in America is, if there is some kind of a thing, then immediately they put an injection or something to sleep them. Sleep. They don't accept all these things, but they put medicines and they will be in a kind of a unconscious state. That is what if the people that have some kind of a thing, they go to the hospital, they will do that. And they will, they will do that. The people are being like that. So, but because the depression is going high in America. Everywhere, depression, medicines are being sold like anything. But people will not, may not agree. But that is the truth. But no, what to do with the possessed? They cannot act on their own. They cannot do anything. They cannot help themselves. Even if you speak the word, they cannot understand anything. Because one thing is very, Jesus Christ had one person who was possessed with how many devils? Legion, thousands. So in this one heart, thousand demons can come in. I cannot understand. But it is a fact. What he was doing, he was scratching his body, all over bleeding. He was hurting himself. He was in chains. He was in a graveyard. He could not, nobody could control him at all. But the moment Jesus said, evil spirit left. Immediately the evil spirit left. He was 100% delivered. He was a man, he had no food, no clothes, nothing. He was just sitting by the side of Jesus as an ordinary man. So what a wonderful God we have. And also, the Bible is very much a thing, our heart should not be kept empty. If you have an empty, the spirit will go out and will take more evil. Seven other spirits, and he'll come back and dwell in the heart. Our conditions will be more worse than the beginning. You see, once don't be aware, don't give your heart. Heart is precious. Don't give your heart to the devil and demons to occupy your heart. The Bible is openly saying, just read that, give heed to that. To avoid unnecessary things, you will be troubled. You will be fighting with those forces only. If you allow, you have a freedom, no? God cannot force you. If you want to go. Go after the films, go after every dirty things in this world, everything, no? Keep your eyes free. Keep your eyes free. Be careful of what you hear. These things will only defile your own heart. mm. this girl followed Paul and us and cried out, saying, "These men are the servants of the Most High God who proclaim to us the way of salvation." It looks like she gives the truth, but behind her was not other evil spirit. So then, no, and this she did for many days. But Paul, greatly annoyed, turned and said to the spirit, "I command you, in the name of Jesus Christ, to come out of her." And he came out that very hour. Just one word from a man of God that delivered that girl. What a wonderful thing it is, no? What a power we have. What a potential we have. What the heavenly resources you have. To deliver the people, those are possessed by the evil spirit and daunted by the spirits. Nobody can deliver, but you and I only can take that challenge. Dear child of God, this is a real challenge that it is the men. We have a lot of things. I'm going to stop with that. I don't want to go to the third point at all. I want to dump so many things today, but I want you to just ponder over these two things. We have so much of things. The more I see, there's so much we have to do for the kingdom of God. So many responsibilities we have. We have to tap the resources of God. And we have to be a blessing to the people around. Do you get the challenge from the Lord today? Are you ready to take up the challenge? People go after many things in this world, but people are in pain. People are in torment. People are in trouble. People are in stress. They don't know what is happening. But the answer is with you and me. We have the solution in our hand. I feel a great thing. So we have to change the hearts. We have to deal with the hearts. First, if we deal with our heart, there are so many hearts that is our responsibility to change. We can change. We can change. So what are we doing? What are we doing? So, God is working in each one of us. Recently we had a voluntary meeting. It is all voluntary work. So much inside the church, I praise God for the work many are doing. Each one, one person to do something. God has given a wonderful church with a burden, with a passion to do for God. We can collectively, we can do it. We can, the gift of, if you start with the burden and operate, the gift of God will operate in us. So we have to just, this word, I want to just think about it and pray about it. Lord, in what direction you want me to move? Spend time with God and find out. Time is going very fast. We do not have much time. But everyone, we have to act for God. What is my work, God? So, we have to appreciate the work of many people. It is not the church, is no. For example, Metro Hope, Healing House. They are the unique ministries that nobody can do. International Justice Mission. That is a one, I cannot say how they are able to do it, but they do it. You see, we cannot, we have such a great potential. There are many people with so many technology, so many talents. You see, we have to join our hands. Join our hands. And we have to put to work. We have a great burden for reach RTC, reach Twin Cities for India. Reach Twin Cities. So these are all, God is speaking, God is raising within ourselves people with the burden. But everything, I want in this church there be so many ministries should happen. So many people should be touched by the Spirit of God. The hearts should be changed. Are you ready for that? Are you ready for that? Are you ready for that challenge? If nothing, you just spend much time in prayer. Prayer is a thing, If you put, so God just speak to us sometimes, but we don't give heed to it. So only the place when you pray, that will get confirmed. That the God will speak more. God, it will be, you share with others. Whatever the Lord speak to you, that share the burden with others. That is why we are as a church. What God give to us, people, whatever you say, first people may not agree. But if it is of the Lord, it will happen. If the Lord gives a tug, don't stop it. Just be on your knees. That is the place that your plan grows. Don't accuse anybody. Don't find fault with anybody. If the Lord gives a plan, be on your knees. God will somehow, even if time, so if it doesn't happen for this time, just wait. There's a time more for God has given you to pray. So if there is a tug from God, He knows how to bring it to pass. So let us become the people of prayer. People giving heed to the Spirit of God. The people whose heart is the Lord is God, Jesus, your Lord. You will make tremendous changes everywhere. Especially, you see, cell groups. No? Gather us two or three people and just share and pray and start small cell groups. Whatever the Lord has put, that may grow in a great magnitude. We don't know how the Lord is going to work, how God is going to lead you. We don't know at all, but our God is able to do mighty things. It started in many things I know, small beginnings. It is started in a very, very small way. Europe, the ministry started with the woman. With the small riverside, few women, it started. The starting They were very small startings. But if you are sincere, God will expand it. God will make you to grow. He is the Lord. Again, I make you to remember this word. The churches were established in faith and grew in number. Grew in, what does it mean? Many hearts. It is not just but really, it is a real, when I look at the acts of the acts, you see there is a real change of heart. You look at it deeply, how God is changed. Our God changes the hearts. That is the way. This is the Bible. We have to see the results. We have to see people change. So if we have problem, it's not easy. It is a hard thing, but our God is able to do that. Our God is able to change that. Everything God is able to work out in our life. Let us all close our eyes. And just let us all stand up. What is my responsibility? Where I stand, Lord? What do you want me to do? Please, please, please consecrate your heart 100% for God. Lord, my heart I will not share with anything but only for you, Lord. Please, please, please don't know for anything. No argument at all. Nothing at all. My heart is 100% to you, Lord. You be my Lord. You be my God. Let me be controlled only by you, Lord. Lord, change my heart. Let our hearts be changed today. Let the Lord, Spirit of God, speak to us. You may surprise the way that God is going to use you. We are standing before the great and mighty God. God will open the heavenly resources for you. God will lead you in a different directions that you never even fathom it. He comes to you as a Lord. He wants to guide you. He wants to take you to the heights. Glorious things He wants to show you. Give your heart completely.
Let's worship. If you're struggling with opening your heart fully Now is the time, church. If you're struggling,